So we'll continue with the static variables and static methods. We did some output questions in the previous session. Now we will try to go and write Java class. So here we have a question that says, you have to create a class named Flower. The class should have two private members, name and price. The class should include a static number, number of flowers, and it should be initialized to zero. The default value for name is rose. The price should be non-negative floating point and the default is zero. So let's try and do the initialization of the private members. So here we will have public class of flower. I have a private string name. We have a private double price. We have number of flowers and it should be static and the initial value is zero. If we remove this static keyword, it means number of flowers will be as a normal variable just by saying it should be static. It means now this is shared between all the variables. Let's continue with the method. It says, additionally, you should have the following methods. You should have a default constructor, so it means a constructor with empty parameters that will initialize the data member to their default values. The default value for name as described is rose, and the default value for price is zero, and we should increment number of flowers. So here we have to do the following. We will have to have a constructor. Constructor always should have the same name as the class. We should have it as public, so I will say public, and I should have it as empty because this is the default constructor. Now, the initialization we have to do is I have to initialize name and I have to initialize price. Name, according to the question, it should have rose as the default value. A price, according to the question, it should be 0.0. Also, because we are creating a new object, we have to increment the number of flowers. So we will go there and we will say number of flowers plus plus. So this is the first one. The second thing I should have, a constructor with parameters for name and price. So I will have a constructor and I will have a new name, a new price, and also will increment number of flowers. So almost we will have the same thing as the previous constructor. The difference is here when I say public flower, I should not leave the brackets empty. I have to include parameters. So I have to say string a new name, and I will have to say double new price. Here, when it comes to the rows, I will remove it and I will say this is equal a new name. When it comes to the price, I will have to say a new price. But we have to be careful with this statement, a price equal a new price. Because according to the question, we have a condition that says price is non-negative floating point. So always it should be as a positive. So it means I have to remove this and I should have an if condition beforehand and I have to say go and check a new price. If it is less than zero, if it is negative, then I have to output a message. And we'll say, for example, error or invalid price. Otherwise, I will say price equal a new price. If you don't set the value, it will take the default value, which is zero. Or additionally, you can put the default value here. You can say price equal 0.0, just to make sure that This is the default value that is initialized in case of invalid of the price. Also, we will have number of flowers plus plus. And then I should have a set method to set the private members name and price if the given values are valid. So I will have a set method. Remember that a set method always should be public. We should declare it as void. Let's call it set flower. I have to take a string, a new name, and I have to take double new price, and then open the brackets, and I should have the coding, and then I have to do the initialization. And the setting method, again, I have to do the same thing. I have to say name equals a new name, and I have to say also the price equal a new price. But again, here price might be invalid. The new price might be invalid, so I have to do a double check. So I will copy and paste the if statement we did in the constructor. I'll say if a new price is negative, output an error, but we have to remove this. I should not reinitialize it to zero. I have to keep the old value, else I'll have to say new price. So I'll just remove the brackets. We no longer need them. So the difference between constructor and set, constructor is called when we create the object, and if the value is invalid, I will set it to the initial value. And the set method is called whenever we need it, just by saying then object name dot set flower. And if the value is invalid, only we output a message. We should not reinitialize it to the default. So this is the set method. As usual, we should have a get method. So I need a get to have name and a private, and I will have a printing method to display the values. So the get method, we will have it as follow. I will have public. We will get the name. So name is of type string, so I'll have to say string, and I will say get name. And we have empty brackets. All what we have to do is we have to say return name. So this is we'll do the returning of the name. Similarly, we will do the same thing, but I will do it for price. So I will say get the price. But because the price is double, so I'll have to change the data type here to double, and I will say return the price. We will do a printing method, so I will say public void the print. We will take no parameters, and all what we have to do is we have to say system.out.println, and I will have to do the output of the name. Let's have for example comma, and then I will have to say price, and again similarly we will have another comma, and then finally we will have the variable number of the flowers. So let me just copy it as it is, and this is we'll do the output, and then we can close the brackets of the printing method. What is remaining? A static method to set the number of the flowers, a static method to return the number of the flowers. So we will come there, and we will say if we need to set, usually we say public void, and we just give it set, and let's say set num, and then we take a new value, so we'll say integer a new num, and then we open the bracket and we close the bracket, and all what I'll have to say that number of the flowers and equals the new num we just have from the parameter. Now, the only thing that I have to remember that this is a static method, so I have to include the static keyword. So if you just recall from the previous sessions we did, if you declare university as a string static, when you have set or get method, also you have to include the static method in order to have them as static methods. So you say public static and then you continue with your method. So similarly, we will do the same thing here and we will just mention public static void set. Maybe we can just use the full name so it will be more, much clearer. So set number of flowers, integer a new number of flowers, then we will save them a number of flowers. Just like we have the set, we will do the same thing with the get. Usually the get is again public. The return type is integer and I will say get number of flowers and we will take no parameters. And the coding we will just do, we will say return number of flowers. Here, remember this is a static, so I'll just need to include the static keyword here, which means now this is shared for the whole class, and then we can use it with the whole thing. And this is, will be the end of our class. So here to recap what we did, we said public class of flower, this is the name of our class. We have name, we have a price, but they are normal variables of type string and double as a private. We have a number of a flower as static, and that's why we included the static keyword, and that's why we have an initial value of zero. Because we have to declare two constructors, default and the one with parameters, the default constructor always will be public and it should have the same name as the class. So if this was called the flowers, it means here I have to call it flowers as well. If this is capital F, then the constructor should be capital F as well. So always we have to be careful with the naming. The constructor, we have to initialize the value. So I have to know what is the value of the name, what is the value of the price. So according to the question, name is roll, so price is zero. And according to the question, go and increment number of flowers. So this is number of flowers, initially zero, it will be incremented. We have the other constructor of flower, but it will take a new name and a new price. So I will take the new name and save it in name. And we will take the new price and save it in a price. But we have to be careful that always it should be positive. So I will have a condition saying if a new price is less than zero, output an error and initialize it to the default value. So for example here, if the new price is minus 10, it will say minus 10 less than zero, output an error. If the new price is 20, 20 is okay, so it will take 20 and save it. And just like we did in the previous constructor, we will also increment number of flowers. According to the question, we should have set method. So that's why we have set a flower. We will take a new name and a new price, save them in name and price. But again, we have to check the price. We have to get method name and price. We will return the name and the price. And we need just to remember the data type, string for name and double for price. Printing method is a void method and we take no parameter. And I just have to output the variables that is required. We have another set method only for number of flowers. And number of flowers is integer. That's why we say here integer, a new number of flowers. Take it and save it a number of flower. And I need it to be static. That's why I have to say public static. So I can use it by using the object or the class name. We have here number of flowers as a get method. That will return integer and also it's declared as a static. So all what we need to say return number of flowers. So this solution will be uploaded as well on a Blackboard. So please go and review it and try to write a main method, another class with public static void main, where you create objects, you initialize values, and then go and call the printing method. So whenever you create object and you do the printing, the number of flowers should be incremented.